One, two, three, and four, and one, two, three, one, two, and four, and one, two, three. Pulse. This is so important. This is where the groove is going to come from. I love the bass. Are there any bass players here tonight? Don't be shy. Like I said, I love the bass player. One, two, one, two, three, four, five, one, two, one. Again, I can sub. I always look for a quarter note subdivision. So it's one, two, one, two, three, four, five, one, two.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, and 2, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Instead of playing the basic pulse, which I'm feeling internally, I'm playing a dotted eighth note with the hi-hat. So it kind of just plays this continuous over the 11, and it sounds like this. If you hear it on its own, it could just be 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, there, three, four. But that's out of context. But you put it in context with the 11, it's 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it takes 3 bars of 11 to come back on 1. Check it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1. So the second bar started on 1 and 2. 4, 1, 3, 1. And then it starts on the second 16. 1, 2, four. And then we're back on the one. So it's just a 3-bar cycle.
Thank you.
3-4 can also be perceived as 6-8 because you're going 1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1. So you can feel it as 1-2-3-4-5-6-1-2-3-4-5-6-1. Depends how you hear it. So let's see how you hear it. We'll be right back. There's a bunch of tracks, and I'll play a few examples while we're on the topic, that are actually based on that quintuplet groove. It's 4-4, but instead of being a normal 16th note, quintuplet. See that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Normally we go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1E and a 2 and a 1. There's some beautiful, you can create some beautiful layers and textures going in and out of that vibe. So that thing I just played, the quintuplet, the five-a-diddle with a paradiddle, you can think of it as this. But you're just feeling this. A lot of possibilities to explore. Here's another example. That click level. All right. So you're going to hear two bar counting. You're going to hear my three bar drum intro, and then the band comes in. Questions on that? Did you kind of get what I'm doing there? Great, cool. Okay. There was the other chap here who had the question. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
Off the mark here, you're a true master, Virgil. Absolutely love your
Thank you. Appreciate it.
The phrasing between your left hand, those notes, and your bass drum, and maybe doing something.
Oh, okay. So he's talking about all the kind of the more nuanced phrases that I play between the left hand ghost notes and the kick drum,
yeah,
and you know, whatever groove it may be. So what you're probably hearing is all these multiple stroke. They're not just single or double stroke ghost notes.
Yeah, especially the ghost notes.
Some of them are like three or four stroke ghost notes. So you're doing this. One, two, three. Maybe occasionally playing two doubles. Kick plays doubles instead of the one beat. So you get this. And you can throw in some accents, right? Now, what about threes, three and one. So now I was playing some of the threes. There's a pulse. One, two, three, four, one. So depending on where you start the group of four, it can fall on any part of the beat. So if I start it with the pulse, it sounds like this. But if I start it after the pulse, the kick drum is going to be in a totally different spot. A bit. Or on the third 16th. How about a group of five 16ths?